So now we'll see the exterior of the heart. The exterior of the heart, first we'll see the anatomical position in which the heart is held. This flat surface of the heart rests on the palm. This is the diaphragmatic surface. And here this is the apex of the heart. Apex of the heart lies between the thumb and the index finger. Diagonally opposite to the apex of the heart is the base of the heart. The base of the heart is formed by both atrium, mainly by the left atrium. This is the base of the heart. And there are three surfaces of the heart. The anterior, this is the sternocostal surface. This left side, this is the left surface. And the surface on which the heart is resting, this surface is the diaphragmatic surface of the heart. Now we'll see how the borders of the heart are dividing these surfaces. The right border of the heart extends from the superior vena cava to the inferior vena cava. This is the right border of the heart. The line is called as sulcus terminalis, this line. This is dividing the heart into, this is the sternocostal surface and this is the base of the heart. So the right border separates sternocostal surface from the base of the heart. And from this inferior vena cava to the apex of the heart, this is the inferior border of the heart. This, my corset is kept here. This is the inferior border of the heart, which separates sternocostal surface from the diaphragmatic surface. This here, this is the diaphragmatic surface. So this inferior border, this separates sternocostal surface from the diaphragmatic surface. The left border of the heart starts from the apex of the heart towards this left auricle. This is the left border of the heart. So left border of the heart separates sternocostal surface from the left surface. Apart from that, there is upper border of the heart which is obscured by these great vessels, the arch of aorta and the pulmonary trunk. These are overlying the upper border of the heart. So now we'll see the interior of the heart. For the interior of the heart, we have cut open the for the right atrium. We have made an incision through the sulcus terminalis, which was the line extending from the superior vena cava to the inferior vena cava. We have cut open the sulcus terminalis to see the interior of the right atrium. The interior of the right atrium shows rough anterior part. This is the rough anterior part and this is the smooth posterior part. So in the rough anterior part, what we can see is the crista terminalis, which gives fibers like this. This is the musculi pectinati. This is the crista terminalis and this is the musculi pectinati. And the smooth posterior part, here this is the fossa ovalis. This is the fossa ovalis. And this margin above, this is the limbus fossa ovalis. And here this is the coronary opening of the coronary sinus. And here we can see the opening of the right ventricle, the right atrioventricular opening, which is guarded by cusp, the tricuspid wall. We'll see the interior of the right ventricle. Interior of the right ventricle shows rough inflowing part and smooth outflowing part. The rough inflowing part is called as trabeculae carnae. Trabeculae carnae has three parts: ridges, bridges, and pillars. Ridges are fixed elevations on the surface of the ventricle. The bridges are connected at two ends and they are free in between. One of the characteristics of such bridge is this septomarginal trabeculae, called as the moderator band, which carries the right branch of the AV bundle. So this rough inflowing part and smooth outflowing part, they are divided by an elevation. This is called as the crista, the supraventricular crest. The supraventricular crest divides the interior of right ventricle into rough inflowing part and smooth outflowing part. This smooth outflowing part is called as the infundibulum of the right ventricle. Apart from that, what we can see is the papillary muscles. There are three papillary muscles in the interior of right ventricle: anterior, posterior, and septal. This is the anterior papillary muscle, and these are the caudate tendinae, which connect the papillary muscles to the cusp. These are the tricusp of the tricuspid wall. So this is the interior of the right ventricle. Note the thickness of the interior of the wall of the right ventricle. We'll compare it with that of the left ventricle. So this is the interior of the left ventricle. So this is 3 times more thick as than that of the right ventricle. The interior of the right ventricle, the interior of the left ventricle also shows rough inflowing part and smooth outflowing part. The rough inflowing part, similarly, it is, here also it is called as trabeculae carne. The smooth outflowing part here this side, this is the vestibule of the left ventricle. Shows similar structures as that of the right ventricle except for the thickness of the wall. It is 3 times thick. And also there are only 2 papillary muscles here, anterior and posterior. In right ventricle there were anterior, posterior and septal papillary muscles. Is the interior of the left atrium. Interior of the left atrium is entirely smooth except for a small part of the area of the left auricle, which is rough. The interior of the left atrium is smooth and it's developed from the absorbed pulmonary veins.